Here's the top three concepts you need to know so that your emails stay in the inbox and don't land in the spam folder. As a deliverability expert at Kit, I've helped some of the largest creators ensure their emails avoid the spam folder. Now I'll break down some of the most common mistakes I've seen, explain how they happen, and show you how to avoid them. But before we break this down, we need to understand deliverability a little bit as a whole. Deliverability is a confusing word with a lot of meaning thrown around, but all it simply means is, are your emails delivered in the inbox or are they delivered in the spam folder? As opposed to delivery, which is the actual ability of the message to be accepted successfully without any type of technical issue. Now, where a lot of creators get mixed up is they think, well, don't most of my emails land in the inbox anyways? I'm not sending bad emails that go against good practices. I'm not sending spam, so surely I'm not at risk. Let me break this myth a little bit. Even if you're doing what you think are the right things, you can still end up in the spam folder and it might not even be something that you realize you're doing wrong. To really avoid it, you need to give special attention to your email list, the people who are subscribed to you. There is a real person on the other side of that email, and they trust you with the information they give you. So let's explore how you can better serve your audience. The first thing to consider is whether your subscribers actually want to receive your emails. To answer this, we need to think about two things. The first is, how did you collect the subscribers' email addresses you have? And two, does every email you send provide value? Think about the hundreds of emails sitting in your own inbox right now. It might sound harsh, but how many of them are genuinely interesting or valuable to you? If your answer is yes to most, you're probably putting a lot of effort and time into curating your own content, and kudos to you. But if you're like the rest of us, like me, the answer is probably no. A common reason that people even mark emails as spam in the first place is unmet expectations. This can happen in two ways. Expectations weren't set at all. If someone gives you their email address, say from purchasing a product, and you start sending a newsletter without asking for permission, it's really easy for them to hit the spam button because it feels intrusive. The second is, expectations weren't met. Even when you set expectations and get permission to send a newsletter, it usually comes with a promise of delivering value. If you fail to deliver on that promise consistently, subscribers might feel misled. This can lead them to mark your emails as spam, which ultimately really hurts your deliverability. A simple way to find out what your audience values is by using the poll feature or subscriber preferences. This allows your subscribers to tell you exactly what they're interested in, helping you craft content that matters to them. The next concept that I'm gonna talk about is about email authentication. This topic gets a little bit in the weeds and it can be a little technical, so we'll just cover a little bit of the basics. Think of it like getting a call from someone with no caller ID. Do you trust that call, or are you more likely to ignore it? It's the same for inboxes. If your emails are not authenticated properly, it can cause some technical issues that can lead to bounces or spam filtering. Now, there's a couple things to keep in mind. These steps that you'll need to take to set this up depends on whether or not you're using Kit as your email sender or another service. If you're using Kit, the process is pretty simple, and there's a link in the description that will help you get started. Another important factor is how many emails you send. If you send roughly more than 5,000 emails any given week, it's really important that you implement authentication. Even if you send fewer than that, it's smart to set this up early, as platforms and mailbox providers are increasingly prioritizing authentication. While you can handle this yourself, I believe in you, it's often worth consulting a deliverability expert. It's easy to miss something, and experts can help you ensure everything is set up perfectly, giving you peace of mind that your emails will land where they should. But having authentication will not be enough to reach the inbox if your list isn't healthy. Many creators see large list size as a determination of success. But a large list full of unengaged subscribers actually hurts your business because it hurts your deliverability. Your email list will naturally ebb and flow. Subscribers come in, subscribers go out. For example, if you run like a wedding topic newsletter, it's likely people will sign up during a specific season of life, but they may not want to continue receiving wedding-related content after their big day. Some of them will unsubscribe themselves, but many won't open the emails at all after a while. And in this case, you want to clean your list often, which means removing those unengaged subscribers. Depending on how you grow and manage your list, you may want to clean once a month, but at the very least, aim for every 6 months. A great way to handle this is by setting up an automated cleanup. For example, if you're sending regular emails and subscribers haven't opened in 6 months, keeping them on your list hurts your deliverability. You'll want to remove those from your list. We want to make sure that the people who do want to hear from you don't have their emails end up in the spam folder. Think of it as weeding a garden. Removing the weeds gives the flowers more room to grow. While there are many factors that affect deliverability, and I could talk about it forever, the one thing I'd love for you to take away from this is how important it is to focus on your audience and what they really want. The healthiest email lists I've seen come from those who consistently provide value and take a creative approach. There is no silver bullet to avoid the spam folder or to land yourself in the inbox. It's all about genuinely working to help the people you're sending emails to. And if you want to receive the best deliverability possible, then you should check out this video from the lessons we learned at Kit from sending 112 billion emails.